Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to 7th semester. The subject which I am having with you people is BRM, Business Research Methods or Business Research Methodology. Some students are calling it Business Research Methods, some are calling it Business Research Methodology. Today is our first lecture of BRM. So, as usual, starting from the very basic definitions along with some important concepts of BRM or Business Research Methods, I have written a short definition for you people over here that BRM or research is the systematic investigation by the use of scientific method. It is a scientific investigation. There is a problem, there is a phenomena, there is a situation. About that problem, phenomena or situation, we are conducting an investigation, but with the system. Systematic investigation means that there is a sequence of activity which need to be conducted, which need to be completed to find out problem of a specific problem or to find out solution for that phenomena or situation. So the systematic investigation by the use of scientific method, how we are reaching to the conclusion, how we are finding solution for that specific problem, obviously we are using a method which is called scientific method, logical method or valid method in order to establish facts and reach new conclusion. In research, we are having a problem, we are having a phenomena, we are having a solution, we want to reach to new conclusion or results or find out or to find out solution about that specific problem. For that purpose, we are using a specified method, and the name of that specified method is scientific method. I will explain the scientific method to you people later on. So this is how we are conducting this systematic investigation with the help of scientific method to reach to the conclusion or to find out solution to an existing problem or phenomena or situation. That overall scientific process or methodology is called research. We are using scientific method in the research. Remember that we are using scientific method in this investigation. Before explaining the scientific method, I have written one classification of the research types. There are many more classification, many more types, but today I have taken just only one classification. It is our first lecture. So there are two types of research. One is called primary research or basic research. Basic research or primary research. Another type of research is applied research. Basic research or primary research means that there is a general problem. There is a common problem faced by all the people or the society or most of the organization. We want to find out solution to that existing general problem. That is called primary research. Ek mushkil e amumi darin va me khayal ke baraye mushkil e amumi ek raaye hal science paida shavad shuma tahqeeq me konen uchi gupta misha primary research or basic research gupta misha. This is one definition of primary research. Another definition of primary research or basic research is that you want to add something extra to the existing body of knowledge. You are conducting research. Let's suppose you want to make your own theory or make your own model or add something new to the existing body of the knowledge. That is called primary research. Second type of research is applied research. As it is clear from its name, applied, it means that a specific organization is facing a problem. You are conducting a research to find out solution for that problem of ABC company. ABC company is a specific company, and that company is having, let's suppose, a problem of high turnover. High turnover means it implies you are coming to the organization, they are hired, and after a very short period of time, they are replaced by new employees, they are leaving the organization, new people are coming, then they are going, they are replaced by the new people. So this is called turnover. High turnover rate is also a problem faced by ABC company, and you are conducting a research to find out solution for that specific problem of high turnover rate which is faced by ABC company. That type of research is called applied research. You are finding a solution for a specific company or one company that is faced by that company. So that is called applied research. Now coming to the explanation of the scientific method, which is the backbone of the research process. Our research is impossible without the use of the scientific method. So there are some 7 steps in the scientific method. Step number 1, question. Step number 2, research. Step 3, hypothesis. Step 4, testing the hypothesis. Step 5, observation. Step 6, conclusion. Step 7, communication. I'm going to explain these steps one by one. Question. Obviously, when there is a problem in the organization, question arises in your mind. Why there is high turnover rate in ABC company? Let's suppose you are the HR manager of ABC company. So this question is circulating or popping up in your mind. So this is question. Why? What is the reason? What makes the employee to run away from the organization or switching their jobs? There is a valid reason behind this factor, behind this variable. Turnover is a variable. So this question is arising in your mind. Step number 2 is research. It is not this overall research. It is an informal research. Let's suppose Shams is the HR manager of ABC company. So Shams is discussing this problem with other managers, with the employees. He is conducting informal research, a simple investigation from his co-worker, colleagues, or he is thinking something from his own mind. So this is how he is reaching to a hypothesis. Hypothesis means farzia, to a statement. Hypothesis means supposition. Supposition which is based on a limited evidence. یک مفکوره یک فرضیه میگیرن و بر اساس امی limited evidence, based on limited information. So he is, let's suppose he is conducting this informal research. He is asking his co-workers, employees, etc. And most of the people are telling him that there is high turnover rate or people are leaving the organization because of low salaries. So he says that there is high turnover rate in the organization, in the ABC company, because of low salary. This is a hypothesis, supposition based on limited evidence, which need further clarification or investigation is called hypothesis. Supposition based on limited evidence, which needs further clarification or investigation is called hypothesis. There are 2 types of hypothesis. We are calling it null hypothesis. Null hypothesis, N-U-L-L, null hypothesis, and alternative hypothesis. Alternative hypothesis, null and alternative. Null, we are representing it by A naught. A naught, small naught. Alternative hypothesis is represented by A1. Null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis, you are representing your supposition. Amu cheez ra ke shuma farz karin ura ba du shakal navishta me kunin, du shakal ura tashri me kunin. One is called null hypothesis represented by A naught, other is called alternative hypothesis represented by A1. In null hypothesis, you are taking the statement negatively, that there is no relationship between the dependent variable and independent variable. You should know the meaning of dependent variable and independent variable. We said that there is a problem, that employees are leaving the organization, there is a turnover rate. So this is a problem. This is the result of some activity. So this is called dependent variable. What variable? Dependent variable. Dependent variable. This is called dependent variable. Why it is called dependent variable? Because the high turnover rate is a variable, and it is because of some other thing. It depends on something. It is the result of some action. That's why we are calling it dependent variable. the result is called the dependent variable. This is the result. This is a problem. And it is because of some other activity, that other activity is called independent variable. Independent variable. Independent variable. Like I told you, that we supposed that because of low salary, people are leaving the organization or there is high turnover rate. So, turnover rate is dependent variable. That is the problem by itself. And it is because of the salary, low salary. So, low salary is independent variable. You got the point? Inshallah. Dependent variable is the problem by itself. And the reason of the problem is called independent variable, which is called low salary. So, this dependent variable and independent variable, we are making a relationship between them. That high turnover rate is because of the low salary. So we are representing it in two ways, negative way and positive way. In one statement, we are making a relationship that high turnover rate is because of the low salary. In other statement, we say that high turnover rate is not because of the low salary. When you are saying, when you are making up negative relationship between these two variables, that is called null hypothesis. That the high turnover rate is not because of the low salary. Null hypothesis. It is called null hypothesis. We are taking it in two ways, negative and positive. The negative is called null hypothesis. There is no relationship between the dependent variable and independent variable. You are writing it over there. Another is alternative hypothesis A1, you are representing it positively, or in simple words, you are showing the relationship between the dependent variable and independent variable, or in other words, we can say that the high turnover rate is because of the low salary, positive connection. That is called alternative hypothesis represented by A1. You should also do some homework on this. And we will be explaining this null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis in other classes also. So in this step, we are building up the hypothesis, then we are distributing this hypothesis into null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. When this is the starting point of your practical research, when you are building up the null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis, after this you are using different statistical tests, which we are calling it step number 4 of scientific method, testing the hypothesis. Whether or this null hypothesis is correct, that there is no relationship between dependent variable and independent variable, or we said that whether this statement is correct, that there is no relationship between the low salary and the high turnover rate, or whether alternative hypothesis is correct, that there is a relationship between the low salary and the high turnover rate. So we are testing this thing with the help of different statistical tests. You have studied in your statistic, t-test, z-test, regression, correlation, frequency distribution, etc. We will explain all these things in coming classes, inshallah. Then when you are conducting the results, so observations are coming with you. Results are coming with you. So when observations are coming with you, it means that you are reaching to step number 6, conclusion. Result is coming. If you are reaching to the null hypothesis, it means that whatever you have taken is supposition. Har chiz rakh ke farz kadabuden ke ami high turnover rate ke asta bahatere dalilish kam mosh astan. ای جا که به نگتیو نل هایپوتیسیس رسیدین به این مطلب استن که او سپوزیشن غلط بودن. The your hypothesis were wrong. The reason is something else, not the low salary. If you are reaching to the conclusion of alternative hypothesis, it means that there is a relationship between dependent variable and independent variable, or in simple words, we can say that you are correct at this hypothesis building step. Over there, you are saying that high turnover rate is because of low salary. So, this is how you are reaching in this step to the observation, either to null hypothesis or alternative hypothesis. It means you got your solution. You find out the problem you find out the solution for your problem of that organization ABC company. Shams, who was HR manager, he has reached to the conclusion. When he reached to the conclusion, he is making a report. He is making the report easily understandable by the whole organization, by all manager. Obviously, all managers don't know the research language. So he is making a simple report in which he is explaining all these things, which is called communication or a research report. So this is called research, in which we are using the scientific method, or in simple words, we can say that in research, what we are doing, actually it is a scientific process, scientific method, by which we are converting the data into information. In general English or in common language of the society, there is no difference between data and information, but in research, there is difference between data and information. Data is the raw information. Malumati khom. Shayad drust bashat, shayad ghalat bashat. Okay, so in research process, we are using a scientific method to convert this data, raw information, into information, into valid information, scientific information. This was your first class of BRM, business research method. Thank you very much, students. We'll see you in next class. Inshallah, have a very nice time.